Good morning, student. So far we have completed module 1 and module 2. Today we are going to start module 3, which is 8051 microcontroller and IoT development both. So in this module we are going to look at all these topics. So first we will look at introduction to microcontroller, and then some introduction to 8051 microcontroller and 8051 instruction set, followed by another microcontroller, which is AT89SA253, and then we are going to look at assembly language, and then we are going to look at different IoT development boards like NodeMCU, ESP8266, Arduino, Intel Galileo and Raspberry Pi. So let's start with introduction to microcontroller. So first of all, microcontroller is a VLSI integrated circuit. So it is like a single chip which contains thousands of components integrated into it, and the different components you can find on a microcontroller are these things. So you can find a central processing unit which does some computation, you can find memory. And typically in a microcontroller, the memory is divided into two types. One is program memory, which contains the program text, and another kind of memory is data memory, where the data in the program is stored, like variables, the values of variables, all these things are stored in data memory. And then we have I/O ports, input-output ports, using which we interface different devices like sensors and all these things. There are some other components like timer, debugger and all these things. So all these components like CPU, memory and all these things are integrated on a single chip. That too, the size of the chip is very small. So that is why this microcontroller is also called as computer on a chip or single chip computer. And as all these components are embedded into a single chip, that is why the microcontroller is also called as embedded controller. And these microcontrollers are everywhere, they are omnipresent. And if you have any doubt by looking at a device whether it contains a microcontroller or not, so what you can do is, if the device is measuring something like measuring the temperature, humidity, etc., or if it is storing some data, or if it does some calculations, or it has controlling and it displays the information, then such a device will have definitely a microcontroller which is embedded in it. Okay? And some of the microcontroller applications, they are used in household appliances like digital TVs, digital washing machines, microwave ovens and all these things. They are used in telecommunications, they are used in automobiles, they are used in aerospace industry, and they are also used in industry. Different devices that are used in industry. And little bit more about microcontrollers. So the very old and the starting microprocessors are Intel 4004 and Texas Instruments TMS 1000. So these are examples of earliest microprocessors, not microcontrollers. So as the time passed, the computational power as well as the complexity of the circuitry and all these things began to increase. So along with that, for a microprocessor to actually function, we need some other hardware like memory, typically RAM, ROM, the I/O devices and all these things which are typically found on a motherboard. So if you look at a computer, inside the computer there is a motherboard. So on the motherboard you can find a square kind of thing which is called microprocessor. Actually, on that microprocessor, we don't have RAM, ROM, and all these things. They are separate. Okay, but the microcontroller, all these components are in a single chip, small chip. So that hardware, when I talk about microprocessor, the hardware includes integrated circuits for the peripheral devices, that is, I/O devices. They need to be connected separately. They are not on the same chip. So when we talk about microprocessor, the emphasis or focus is on computational power rather than on control. Okay? So as the time passed by, the people wanted to control the hardware, not attach the hardware. So for that purpose, they created new devices which are called microcontroller. So it is an integrated circuit where on a single chip you will find typically all the hardware components. So you can see here in the last point, on the microprocessor, the computational power is more important, whereas in case of microcontroller, computational power is less important. Okay, rather the integration of components is important in a microcontroller. And some of the advantages of microcontroller. So microcontroller is a single chip which contains all the hardware as we have seen until now. And there is no need of any external interfacing because all those things are already on the chip itself. And microcontroller doesn't require complex operating system. Okay. But if you look at microprocessors, they need complex operating systems like Windows, Ubuntu, Linux versions and all this. And all the I/O ports are programmable on a microcontroller. And integration of all these components reduces the cost that need to be spent. So these are the advantages. So as it has advantages, it also has some disadvantages. So typically, whenever you need computation power, that is the focus is on the computation power, then we should not use microcontroller. Okay? And there are limits on memory, how much memory is supported. Typically, on a microcontroller, the memory is very less. Typically, in the order of megabytes. But if you look at microprocessor, that is the computer, memory is nowadays in GBs and even on in TBs, terabytes. So as there is no operating system, all the instructions must be manually written. Okay? So these are the disadvantages of microcontroller. And when you look at a microcontroller, the general layout in of a microcontroller is like this. So it has some CPU, and it has some RAM, and it has some flash memory, it has timer module or counter module, it has interrupt controller, and it has analog module for analog I/O, and it has digital I/O module, and finally it has serial interface module for programming the microcontroller. So I am not going through all these things. You can just pause the video and have a look at these things. So processor core, memory, and for processing events we need interrupt. So there is an interrupt controller. And for things related to time, we have timer controller counter module, and we have digital I/O module for digital input output. And similarly, we have analog I/O module for analog input output. And microcontroller supports different kinds of interfaces. So like serial peripheral interface, SPI interface, inter-integrated circuit interface, CAN interface, PCI interfaces, and USB interface, and Ethernet interface. So all these interfaces are for attaching different devices to the microcontroller. And we have timer module. This is a watchdog timer module. This is different from the previous timer or counter module. So to protect our device from errors or crashes, we use this watchdog timer. And then for debugging the program, we use the debugging unit. So these are the different components in a microcontroller. And finally, I will close this session with some differences between a microprocessor and microcontroller. So microprocessor is general purpose, whereas microcontroller, it is a microcomputer by itself, but it is used for specific purpose, not general purpose. So for example, if you look at a microwave, it is used to bake the food. Other than that, you can't do anything on the microwave. Similarly, if you take a dishwashing machine, you can wash the clothes. Other than that, you can't do anything with that. So all the hardware is not available inside the chip in case of microprocessor, but in case of microcontroller, all these components are integrated on the single chip. And so microprocessor needs extra components to work, whereas microcontroller does not need this additional component because they are already integrated on the chip. In microprocessor needs additional components, the device becomes bulkier and as well as expensive, whereas microcontrollers are economic and small in size, and microprocessors are generally not capable of handling Boolean functions, whereas microcontrollers are capable of handling Boolean functions. Since complexity is high, microprocessor requires more time for access, whereas microcontrollers, since they are small, they need low access time. And the microprocessor, very few pins are programmable, whereas microcontroller, almost all the pins are programmable. And the bit handling instructions available on a microprocessor are very less, whereas the microcontroller, it is more. So microprocessors are generally used in modern day PCs, laptops and smartphones, whereas microcontrollers are generally used in control systems. And some examples, famous examples are microprocessor 8086, Intel Pentium series chip. And examples of famous microcontrollers, Intel 8051, 81960 and PIC16F877. So when we talk about IoT, the popular microcontrollers used in IoT applications are, you know, these things, Atmel series microcontrollers, Microchip microcontrollers, NXP microcontrollers, Texas Instruments microcontrollers, Renesas. We have Expressif, these are very popular, ESP8266 and ESP32, and we have Intel 805. So that is about introduction to microcontrollers. Thank you.